What's up, guys, and welcome back to another video. All Blacks, Bledisloe Cup champions for the 18th time in a row. Holy cow, what an amazing achievement for this phenomenal rugby team. Unfortunately for the Wallabies, they have to go to back to a familiar place, which is the drawing board, as they did not show up against the All Blacks. They dominated from the front, outstanding skills. Richie Mwanga could take a bow. It was just remarkable rugby coming from the All Blacks, once again proving why they are still one of the greatest teams in world rugby and how they just progress, grow, develop, change things up and do things wonderful. The Bledisloe started off very interesting. I mean, you see the 16-all draw, but I've said it before and I'll say it again. A team like the All Blacks come back. They never have repetitive, disappointing games. They really go back to the drawing board, analyze their mistakes and capitalize on them and make sure that they don't make those mistakes again. A lot of people are saying, can we compare this All Black team? Because the Wallabies are just not in a great place. Yes, it was an experienced team. Yes, there were some challenges and all that stuff. But you cannot fault or discredit the performance from this All Black squad. It was really, really great. Discipline was a costa in certain aspects. 11 penalties conceded from the Wallabies, 9 for the All Blacks. It's not as bad. We've seen worse, but they will need to work on that. Obviously, the two yellow cards in the game, not good ones to remember. And I'm sure the All Black fans will be wanting to also kind of forget about that. Two yellow cards for the All Blacks, one yellow card for the Aussies. And I mean, yellow cards are the things we don't want to have. Even with two yellow cards, they still managed to go 43-5. I think it's the highest score that the All Blacks have done against the Wallabies, which, yeah, it's biggest ever win over the Wallabies, which is absolutely remarkable, and all credit and respect to them for that. If we look at some of the set pieces in the game, All Blacks 100% with the scrums. 9 out of 9, 13 out of 14 lineouts, so only losing the one. Australia 100% with their scrums, which is great. 11 out of 13 lineouts, one, not bad at all. Possession territory, New Zealand take that one, 57 in possession and 56 in territory. Really looking good and doing well, credit to that. But Australia, I mean, obviously they had the possession because they were in defense mode, and New Zealand just capitalized on the points. Meters run 414 and 428 to the All Blacks. So interesting stats there. Obviously, Big Cole getting the points in the 5th minute. Great stuff. Richie Mwanga, 2 tries, 21st, 27th minute. Remarkable stuff. Dane Cole's 30-minute try. Ricky Ioane in the 71st, 74th. Jordy Barrett, even though he got a yellow card. The All Blacks just didn't stop. They didn't end there. They were just going at it. And then Richie obviously getting 80% kicking ratio, which isn't bad. Australia nothing, as they missed the converted try by Noah. So, yeah, so much to talk about. Obviously, they're facing each other again. And I think Australia are going to be sick of facing the All Blacks. But it's the way this new layout of the Tri-Nations and obviously Bledisloe Cup games are going to go. But, yeah, Wallabies just need to really pick up and go back to the drawing board and do what they do best and focus on getting the right players. Understand why they went for some youngsters, and I mean, they're good names there. They want to develop, they want to grow, and I mean, this is the way forward for Australian rugby, is the future. Right now, it's a whole rebuilding phase. We've got 3 years until the Rugby World Cup final in 2023. Now's the opportunity to just focus on the important part of redeveloping a team and getting Rugby Australia back to the level of what they've been in the past. They've won the World Cup twice before. They've got the respect. They've got the team. They just need to regroup and restructure. They need to produce what they produced a few weeks ago when they were 16-all win. Yes, Rico Ioane fumbled the ball and they didn't get the try, but also Australia also missed out on opportunities too. So they need to just get that focus from what they had there and bring it towards them into this game going at it. But really outstanding stuff from the Wallabies, and I hope for the sake of rugby in Australia that they can bounce back. I mean, this was a home game. There were some fans in the crowd. They had everything in their momentum, but they just did not show up on the game. I mean, All Blacks started off, like I said, big call, fifth minute try, boom. It was buzzing. It was electric. The skillfulness, like I said, from the boot of Richie Mwanga was remarkable. I was extremely impressed with what the All Blacks were playing. It was exciting rugby. I mean, I hate the score being 43-5. I want a competitive score. But when you see the remarkableness of what these guys did and how they unfortunately demolished the Wallabies, it just went to go and show that they were brilliant. I mean, the anthems of both teams were remarkable. The goosebumps were there. The haka was powerful. But the Wallabies were showing that that momentum, that passion. And through that passion, I was expecting a hell of a better game from the Wallabies. But you know what? It's done. We now move forward. We focus on how they're going to take on the All Blacks again, what they're going to do to Argentina, and how they're going to progress. That's the way forward. As for Ian Foster and the All Blacks and Sam Kang, take a bow, boys. You did well, and you deserved it. And Rick Chimawanga, take my hat off to you, Boyki, because 2 weeks ago, we weren't sure about you. 2 weeks later, you just pretty much showed us why you are the current All Black fly-off. Phenomenal game, and I look forward to the next one. That's going to do it for this review. I hope you enjoyed it. Give it a thumbs up, subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys real soon for another one. What a game. What a tournament. Congratulations to the All Blacks. Bledisloe Cup champions. Stay safe and never give up. Cheers.